Good day, friends and good people of the world. It's the Big Heavy, and I'm back with another brief look at the Jackery 1500. And now that these have started to get out in the wild, you've probably seen videos answering important questions like, how does this unit perform in a complex, dusty, and dirty overlanding environment? Will it work for me in the event of a major power outage or other disaster? But what you haven't seen, and what's missing, is can this device make me a quality latte in the event of a zombie apocalypse? Now you may be saying this is an utterly frivolous video, a cheap stunt designed solely for clickbait and with no real purpose or information to be gleaned, and you would be absolutely correct. So without further ado, let's jump right into seeing if this orange and black device will make us a good latte. I've got it connected currently to my Breville Oracle Touch espresso machine. We're gonna make a latte, and maybe there is some sort of scientific basis to this test, and that's that this is a dual burner espresso machine, so there's two boilers in there that are gonna have to heat up some water. There's a mechanical grinder in here that's presumably a motor of some sort. There's a computer and screen that control it all. So I think this is going to be a pretty heavy load on the Jackery. I haven't tried this before, so we may well trip the Jackery. It may not be able to handle this. But we're going to see what kind of power draw there is, what kind of run times we get, how this Jackery performs when connected to a large device that kind of does the worst possible thing you can do to a battery pack like this. And that's connected to something that needs to generate quite a bit of heat. So we'll hit the display there. We've got 66% currently in the Jackery. Didn't want to start with a full tank. Wanted to let it run down and kind of simulate a situation where maybe you've used this to charge some other devices and you're getting ready to make your coffee. And let's see how she does. Turn on the inverter on the Jackery, which turns on these AC outlets. You'll hear the fans spin up. The fans on the Jackery are variable, so they will kind of ramp up or down depending on how much load we're putting against it. Right now they're kind of at a pretty low hum, so let's turn on the coffee maker. And this unit will start heating up the boilers immediately after you turn it on. So you can hear the fans spinning up on the Jackery. It's now putting out almost 1200 watts. It's got like 1160 on the display. And if you can see on the screen, the coffee maker is telling me that it's heating up the two heating elements. Again, double boiler, there's a heater for hot water, which is used to make espresso, and there's a heater for the steam side of the device, which we'll use to make our latte. So we'll let this guy warm up, we'll get our milk ready, and we'll make some coffee. And I'll keep that display up to the extent I can. It does automatically turn off, which is one of the things I dislike about the Jackery. I wish they would have offered an option where you could just turn it on and keep it on. If nothing else, it makes videos like this easier. I think in use, it's probably a little less relevant since you're not necessarily going to be staring at the screen and marveling at the watts the device puts out. Now, I mentioned earlier, probably the worst thing you can do to a device like this is ask it to generate a lot of heat, which is exactly what we're doing right now, heating up these two boilers. And you can see we're still pulling 1160 watts. That seems to be relatively consistent. And our runtime meter on the Jackery has gone down to 0.6 hours. So, you know, by my math, that's about 35, 36 minutes. So you can see how much pulling electricity to generate heat really runs down your battery quickly. So hopefully we can get this guy heated up. I would imagine that it's going to go to a little bit more of a steady state once the boilers have heated up, and it'll ramp down some of that power usage. So, you know, if this were a real life situation where for whatever reason you were off the grid and needed to make a dozen cups of coffee, you could hopefully pull that off. So we'll see what happens as this heats up. Right now the boiler says it's at 117 degrees. I think it needs to get up to 180, 190 before we can make coffee. So we'll keep going. And actually, to add to the challenge of this test, we might as well grind some coffee beans while those boilers are heating up. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the grind and see what happens to our power usage. So if you saw that, we hit 1300 watts a couple times, seemed to go around high 1200s once the grinding got a little more consistent. So put a pretty good load on this. I believe the Jackery's rated for 1500 watts kind of the long term, and then an 1800 watt peak, I believe. I'll double check that and put those numbers in the video, but we didn't hit our peak and didn't really seem to struggle too much. Fan seems to be pretty consistent. The time remaining meter did pop down to 0.5 hours, and now looks like it's back up to 0.6. So seems to update fairly regularly, which is nice. Now you can see the output has started to drop a little bit. I assume as this heats that it lowers its energy demands a little bit. We've dropped down to about 800 watts of output, and the usage meter has correspondingly gone up to 0.8 hours. So as our consumption drops, that time remaining meter is going up, which is nice. And it looks like we are getting close to being warmed up on this lovely machine. So I'm going to get my milk in place and get ready for making my latte. It looks like our boilers are now up to steam. If you can see that, we've got the two green lights on there. And output's still 800 watts, so it seems to still be drawing some juice. So let's get our milk steaming, and then we're going to make our espresso. And interestingly, not a lot of power draw for the steam side. Let's get brewing here. I don't know if you saw that, but I accidentally set this to make an Americano, so it started throwing some boiling water into my espresso. Luckily we caught that in time, I think, so it shouldn't be too much of a diluted latte, but there is a latte function on here that would have made me a little less coffee and wouldn't have tried to throw that boiling water in at the end. But from a Jackery perspective, we're still rocking about 1,000 watts to steam up our milk here. Is the end of that process, so. All right, so let's clean our steam wand. Let's see what that does. I assume there's some pumps behind that process. So we went about 700-800 watts to do that. Get our espresso in there. I like just a little bit of sugar since I am a bit sour.
And now we're down to, it seems to be bouncing around between 0 and 200 or 300 watts. I would imagine that's kind of keeping the boilers hot, which is good. We've got a delightful looking latte there, and yep, that would work. So not only can this unit keep your medical devices functioning, keep your food safe when you're out in the wilderness or the desert on some expedition, power your critical infrastructure, can also make you a heck of a latte. So can the Jackery latte? Yes, it can. Thanks for watching, and tune in next time for more abject nonsense. If you like this, hit subscribe. If you didn't like it, hit subscribe too. Show the man that you don't listen. Peace.